shit.
The police, the guards are using grenades. They are throwing smoke bombs, grenades, and tear gas.
I know there were four. I didn't know there were five. There's five?
They shot me in the fucking head.
Oh, they're fucking shot. Shit.
George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd!
Not for me.
You're such a filmmaker. I said I thought you were gonna have your own film. You do it, and I'm gonna be there and say I told you so.
Yeah, we could have done it.
Are you sure you're not gonna want these? You should take them to go. Why don't you just take them at
home? I'll go.
I think you can go.
You like this lighting?
Yeah, nothing much. Having a COVID Christmas in this motherfucker. Yeah, I really want this shit to be over. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I really, really want to perform again. That shit used to tire me out, and I hated touring so much, but I miss it badly now. I'm dying to spit in someone's mouth.
You're gonna give it, well, it's gonna be different, I think, for sure.
It's just gonna have a different energy. It's gonna be like a comeback Super Bowl type energy. I'm definitely gonna have a lot of material to release.
I feel like you said it's gonna be definitely different combos.
Yeah, it's gonna be different. I'm just gonna have more material. My show is gonna morph. You know, I'm gonna try to have it's gonna get more theatrical, but I'm gonna always bring that brutality. The minute we can perform live again, it's fucking on.
Can you tell I'm smiling?
Yeah, because your eyes.
Okay, cool.
Only because your eyes.
Do you ever smile at people with your mask on, but they can't tell you're smiling because you don't want to be rude because they smile first?
Are you wearing lingerie?
No. I am.
You're ready.
It started.
Yeah, all this cooking up a nigga feel like super mesh. Don't know how I manage, nigga, I'll be super stressed. Facts. I don't life a bitch, I fuck a shot of LES. You can get the wide shot with the IMAX. Used to be immature, now a nigga feel like IMX. Wait, how these niggas started acting black at 28? Talking out on Peggy, but you grew up in a gate. Fire and desire to my blicky on a date. These suburban niggas ain't really hungry and I don't eat. I do this cause I have to, you do this cause you look them in their eye, put these suckers in their place. Killer instinct, ice on me like glacier. Body slender beat, I'm a young Jake Hager. Late to register, but fucking nigga, we made ya. Bitch, stop running, you is not Ralph Nader. Spit up in the ass, she talked to me like a hater. Wet, looking for respect. Load up the tech, bitch, take it off my neck. Know a nigga blessed, cause my daddy never prayed for less. Sleep with a vet. Bald head nigga, when I spit up in the ass, she gon' call me Lex. I feel like Jordan versus Thomas, niggas getting swept. Niggas who never believe in me, steady seeing red. Now get the Kotex. Been on this horse for a while, guess I'm Bojack. I'ma sleep when I die, hope you know that. I'm digging deep, I gotta recoup, I better own that. I gotta say what's on my mind, fuck the blowback. I know the swine at the priest ain't hot, little piggy, where you cold
at? Damn, Peggy.
Big business, smoking Billy K, dressed like Lipschitz. But watch your enemies fail, I got a hit list. I ran a dead cop audio through Big Mick. That's just the casualties of wars, never cryptic. I break the fourth wall, nigga, stay scripted. But look, we coming for you, now can you dig it? You been lying and you still wanna kick it. Serve a cop 2-piece with a biscuit. I'm not the same as these rappers, there's a difference. Hear it in my beat, see it in my mentions. Little anxiety mixed with the tension. Rules never look good till you bend them, break it. Whoa, man, tell the 5-0 suck my dick. Heard y'all house on fire, it's lit. Man, fuck Trump, I'm bucking that Higgs. New sauce, new year, new drip. Got 2 Glock 19s, they twins. Keep y'all foot up on the neck of them pigs. Strap up before I ever get strapped in. Fuck out the way if you tap dance in. Stop.
You know what I found out about you tonight? I think you're more of a DC than Marvel fan, and I'm kind of hurt.
Why do you think that?
Because you kept, like, in defense, speaking about DC.
I wasn't defending them. I was just like, you just be ignoring what I be
saying.
Yeah, it's like 2:10 probably. Did you bring a mic by any chance? Because I also brought a mic just in case.
No, I didn't bring a mic. You don't have to mic it.
You sure?
No. Yeah. I'm going to just keep it real with you, dog. Because, like, I gotta be transparent about how, like, my last 48 hours have been. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I, like, since the George Floyd shit happened specifically, I made it a point to make sure that if anyone that I'm associated with on a corporate level says anything about this shit, then I'm involved. You know what I'm saying? So, seeing the response from RCA is like absolutely brilliant. Like, lack of response. We need transparency. In this specific moment in time, whoever's aligning with us, we need loud, vocal transparency. You know what I'm saying? When I saw that, basically, I called my A&R and I was like, I need to get in touch with people.
Oh, I love names.
And I'm realizing that, they're having all these little meetings at this company and shit like that. What's the point of having 12 meetings in a day if 14 people in the room are white, 2 people in the room are black, and one person that's black disagrees, and you go to all the other 13 white people in the room before you go to the next black person and be like, well, what do you think? Suck my dick.
Sure.
So I want to be involved in those meetings. You know what I'm saying? I want to be involved in everything. I want to be able to galvanize my people to have transparent conversations about their blackness in front of these corporations. Without having their employment at risk, without having any of that shit at risk. We deserve to be able to have that at the least a fucking start. So y'all know where the fuck we coming from. You gonna hear my pain today. That's exactly what I told them. Once they get an open forum available for people like me and you to be able to at the very least have the autonomy of a choice to opt in on the conversation, then I really don't give a fuck what they talk about. You know what I'm saying?
You heard Sweetwater donated to Trump or something?
I heard that, yeah. Sweetwater's a fucking lost cause. But Splice is, at the very least, Splice is a liberal-facing tech company.
Yeah.
So it's easy to hold them accountable. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Easier, at least, to hold them accountable.
Easier.
It's easy to start the conversation. That's the precedent that I'm setting with every white company that I have any conversation with about this shit. And if they don't want to have a conversation, they're on the wrong side of history.
Man, I just never thought I'd see the day.
Hey, man, I appreciate you inspiring me.
Oh, man.
Thank you, man. The conversations we had definitely have, stirred me up.
Man, it's so crazy.
That shit is wild. This is the only time in the world where this thing fucking happens,
bro. When it's gonna happen.
This is like a pocket, and I'm trying to take the most out of it as I fucking can, bro.
So, no, because I don't want to have to do it again.
Yeah, you're good.
This is the only time. I've thought this too. I have a lot of thoughts on it, but to respond to what you said, yeah, I've thought this too. This is the only time we're gonna have the opportunity to make demands, sort of.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why, you know, every time I mention something, if I see some shit, I'd immediately be like, no, and you need to do this. Like when I saw the Blackout Tuesday thing, and at first I didn't really know what it was, so I didn't say anything. I try not to speak on things I really don't. I try to talk what I know, not what I think.
Yeah.
But as I kept looking deeper into that, it was like, this is just a way for those people at RCA who are waiting for 4 days, not saying anything. This is a way for people who haven't said anything to get their participation trophy and be like, I did it. Look at my black square.
Absolutely.
And it was just like, I wasn't gonna allow that to happen with at least me saying that. No, you guys prey on black people constantly. The music industry is basically based on preying on black people.
Absolutely.
Pretty much. So I don't know how you think that you're going to erase that with a black square.
Mm-hmm.
And then the conversation needs to go further. Like, are you going to let the people off those deals you signed?
Exactly.
Are you going to donate money like you say you are? Mm-hmm. Are you going to, how much? Where are you going?
Exactly.
Because you guys are liars.
Yeah.
You have, over the years, they have earned our distrust. So we can't give them the benefit of the doubt on anything. So we need to see everything every step of the way. I'm laughing at what you said, not because I think it's funny or anything. I don't want anybody to get it twisted.
No.
I've been talking that. When I started rapping, the first thing I started rapping about was this shit. So
yeah.
I've been talking about this too long.
Both of us.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, this has been a big concern.
Like, that's why we're both so well articulate at this shit. Because we have like 6 years of a head start on this shit. We're like, we already like, the 12 stages of grief, nigga. Like,
it's been there. Like, we've felt like this when everybody else wasn't feeling like this, basically. So, like, I'm not laughing because I think it's funny. I'm laughing because it's like, funny. Finally. I never thought I'd ever see the day where you would have the ability to do that to us.
Same.
Like, I
didn't either, yo. And yeah. In the conversation, I was like, yo, I feel like someone smarter than me, somebody more famous than me should be doing this shit. But at the end of the day, if they're not, fuck it. I am. Like, that's where I'm at.
I'm realizing now, especially in the music industry, and maybe it's in every industry, but it's set up in a way so that it's presented like making the decisions at the top seems like this impossible thing. But when you really dust off the surface and look at who's at the top, they're not really that smart. And a lot of them aren't smarter than us at all. But we just have this assumption. But it's like, how smart are you? You know, they have the access. So they can fit the narrative. How smart are you actually? So let's dust off the shit and let's see how smart you actually are. Because if you're not like that, then fuck you, get out the way. Mm. And like, yeah, a lot of my career since I've got in has gone like that. Like me being like, what? Like, bro, when I first got in, I asked them, because I needed a place where I could see my tour, like stuff, like how much, where am I going? Where am I going to be? When are my great days off? Where am I, how much money am I going to make? Like, I need to see all that on a grid. And I don't know if they lied to me or what it is, but they responded to me like this was some crazy idea that's never been done before. And I was just like, in what world
am I not get your allowed schedule for work? Like, what the fuck?
In what world am I not allowed to see my own money?
Yeah.
It's my money. You can't tell me I can't see my own money. It's like, so I can't see my money? Okay, we're not making any more money then. So, like, my entire career has basically been, like, me trying to do things and then people inventing rules to stop it. But I'm just like, you know what? Everything in the music industry is made up. Have you ever read a music industry contract? It's all stupid shit. We own all your shit in the universe forever. What? Nigga, that's not even a real thing.
So the artists don't have leverage.
They don't have leverage and they don't know any better. Mm-hmm. It's all the whatever. Still failing through. Somebody who doesn't have this shit is going to die out here. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just like college. My bad, I didn't mean to rant, but it's just like the college shit. The college shit. When they go to these kids, it's real predatory. They're like, oh, he looks good. I like that. Why don't you come in? They do the same thing with niggas. They're like, oh, you have a painful past? That'll make a great story. We like that. You know what I'm saying? It's the same shit. And it's like they prey on people and they make it so that they don't even own what they're rhyming. it's set up to be predatory, bro. And it's like,
absolutely.
It's terrible. And I'm glad that now, because this conversation wasn't even about music. It was just about black people dying
and unlawfully. For real,
And this opened up the floodgates for everything. So I'm glad that you're able to call up the president of RCA and put pressure on them.
They're all just having meetings in the office. Like, it's another day. You know what I'm saying?
You know what they're trying to do?
There's nothing galvanizing happening.
They're trying to figure out how to cover their tracks. That's what the meetings are really about. The meeting, they're not sitting around being like, you know, guys, black people die every day. I think so. Can you imagine the president of, what's his name?
Oh, my God.
Peter Edge? Can you imagine Peter Edge and then, let's see, the president of, like, Atlantic, Craig Kellerman, and, the Lucian Grange all in the room, like, you know what, guys, this shit has to stop now. Like, no, they're not doing that shit. They're just like, what do we need to say and do, and how do we need to move in order to look the best so we can continue to exist? Because our entire lives are based on preying on these motherfuckers, so, like, how can we continue to do that
and
safely?
See, the thing that
what else can you do?
Facts.
After all these years of what, like, it's too much to think.
Like, for me, it has nothing to do with capitalism, it has nothing to do with socialism, it has nothing to do with any ism, it has everything to do with the principle of getting what the fuck out of here.
Absolutely. It's complete principle. Everything, the way that they operate is the way that we should operate when we don't. Because we have We have no access. Like
the access and the amount of resources is literally dictated by them. They're just like, you want a little bit of this? Here, you can make t-shirts. Like, oh, you want to make clothes? No, t-shirts.
It's crazy. Like, it's crazy that the industry is set up that way. That it's like, when I first was trying to get in, they drilled it into my head that you're never going to make money off your music. You might as well just sell shirts based on your music, because somebody at the top is going to be caking off of that. Mm-hmm. And I just, my mind refused to let that. I was like, nah, man, I don't know about that. if you didn't pick a snare,
that's what I'm saying, man.
Layer a kick, make them fucking, if you didn't do none of that, you shouldn't be able to say how dictate where it goes.
Absolutely. This one that I was having with another person, and they were explaining to me how audio streaming platforms need to be decentralized. And I was like asking them about like how that happens. You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you crowdsource or crowdfund an audio streaming platform that's like, to make it such a thing that's where it needs to come from, like Bitcoin. They haven't figured it out yet. but the fact that I'm having conversations with those people who know, who have access to the technology, the first time I'm having the access to that shit.
Butterfly.
I love them.
I'm just hot. this is the first time we're ever be able to sit in these meetings and talk to these people and actually have them listen because they have to. This is the way. You have to speak to these people. You can't make them empathize because they don't have it. They don't actually care about these issues, and there's no way to make them magically do it. Make 60-year-old white men care about black people. They just won't. So we have to make them put their money where their mouth is. Money talks.
Yep.
And when you invest in something, it's invested, no matter what the person thinks.
So, he said something along the lines of, we got to make sure that we're seeing the finish line before we take that first step. And I think that I'm in the moment of taking these first steps right now, and I'm starting to have a vision of what a finish line can be for you. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. And that finish line isn't necessarily a thing. It's an idea. And that idea is black ownership and black equity. You know what I mean? Like I think that
because
that's
that lasts, and
crucial starting point.
Yeah.
So crucial.
Because that'll set up a foundation so that everything can be built up. I don't know. I just feel like...
Because this performative shit is exhausting, bro.
Yeah, it's too performative.
It's so exhausting.
If we have our own thing, we can make... We don't have to adhere to the rules, so that can be a thing. It doesn't have to be just like a punchline.
Like seeing somebody on TV like, yo, I'm fucking tired. Like, come on, yo. Like,
did you... By the time George Floyd happened, I'd become so desensitized to seeing black people get shot in the street. It was almost like I avoided looking at it. I was like, I had grown accustomed to the response, which was outrage, then silence, and then we move on. And then we go back to whatever the fuck we were doing. So when it happened, I'm just like, let me just avoid that at all costs. I don't want to feel that. I'm not even in it. It's like, you get tired of feeling...
It's not your right to feel any of that shit. It's white people's job to feel that shit. It's the people who's responsible's job to feel that shit.
But see, this wasn't a conversation until right now. Mm-hmm. So I'm saying, like, before...
Yeah.
There was a glass ceiling. There was a cap.
Absolutely.
On, like, where it went. So, yeah. Like, as someone who is logical and a logical, sane human being, I didn't feel like... It's sad that I felt, like, not mourning for people that look just like me.
Well,
because
see,
the response I knew was going to get.
It's
now,
not
this one,
that you're not mourning, though.
No, I was mourning, but like I avoided discourse about it because I'm like, I can't go down that road because I know where it leads to a dead end.
Totally fair to you. Yeah. I think for us as black people, specifically in this moment, it's respectable for us to be able to draw that boundary for ourselves and for the people around us. We deserve that.
That's true. I don't have it now. I'm saying before that.
I'm speaking also on that perspective of like being one of those, like, because I was also one of those people, like I had to decondition myself from seeing that shit. And part of it, like I remember having a very vivid night terror before I had to take a road trip from Connecticut to Los Angeles because I got my car in Connecticut and I drove down here. Mm-hmm. This was in 2015 or 16, 2022. And I remember this was like right after the Mike Brown thing happened.
Yeah.
And I woke up, and basically like the dream was that I got accosted by a police officer in a gas station. And as I'm walking out, they said something. I turned around, I didn't hear it, and I walked back out. And when I walked back out, I got hit right in the face with a running baton. They beat me to death. And it happened in my dream. And I remember seeing white light. Like, the light, I remember seeing the light of God in my dream. And then you know how, like, when you see a white light, it's like completely bloomed out, and then it might eventually, like, come into focus? Like,
yeah.
That's what I felt, that sensation happening. And when that light closed and I was able to get into focus, it was a fucking light on the camera phone. After that, bro, I was like, that's it. I'm never looking at that shit again.
Yeah, when it's in your subconscious like that, it'll pop out in weird ways.
But I get it. Like,
but to go back to what you said earlier, it's because of their response to it is why that reaction. Because the response should be, you f- feel pain, you say something about it. There's a discourse, and then hopefully it becomes some kind of medium. What was usually, what's happening before this was, there's a discourse, nobody gives a shit, and then everything goes right the fuck out. Like, literally goes right, statistically and everything.
Yeah.
It's just like, it's so funny to me, like, we've had these same discourse over and over again, but yet you look at police killings every year, and they just go up and up and up, and I'm just like, what are they doing? Mm-hmm. What's the discourse doing? That's why I stopped having them. That's, yeah.
That's why I'm like, fuck discourse action. You know what I'm saying?
This time, I think everybody at this point was feeling that. Mm-hmm. I guess, I thought maybe just a few people were feeling that, but I guess the entire country collectively, as black people as a whole, we were mentally, subconsciously done by the time the George Floyd shit happened. So,
and like, the thing about it is, I wasn't as angry about this conversation when I was ready to have it with RCA on the first day. But over the course of 4 days, they pepper sprayed a fucking black senator. Like, all this other, like, more black people died. You know what I'm saying? Like, they tried to blame the fact that there's looting on justification of killing more black people. And you're telling me wait until the weekend is over? Wait until Blackout Tuesday and I give you a call?
That's
come on.
Wait until Blackout Tuesday.
Good. I told them, good, at the end of the day, if y'all don't take action, I'm going to keep applying pressure.
Good. But one thing I want to talk about as well, I want to talk about the, so every time this happens, no matter what, this is the most serious I've ever seen it. Precincts, mm-hmm, burned down. These are the kind of things I've rapped about, wanted to happen. Mm-hmm. And, you know, of course, I have to participate. Not in burning down precincts, but I have to participate in the protests.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, so I've been... I went to like a bunch of protests, but I want to talk about what I saw there, but I want to talk about something else. Mm-hmm. What do you think about this expectation that you have to say something, otherwise it doesn't count? Because, for example, I donated to, there was a thing going around, mm-hmm, that like share, match, mm-hmm, this thing,
yeah,
and I saw people matching it. I donated more money than most people did. Yeah. I didn't like whatever, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm wondering if there's artists like that who are doing that and just who aren't active on social media. Is it unfair to them to like expect them to get on there? Or is it like, this is more serious than that, get your ass on Twitter and say some shit?
It's a 50-50. Because I had a conversation with No Name about this actually. And she was the person who inspired me to publicly post my match. Because originally I just sent it to her, like, I got you. And that's what I always do. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've always been a silent benefactor. I follow Prince in that aspect of that sense. Like, Prince was always a silent benefactor. And he was always giving money to black people, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Like, this whole team was, like, full of black women, like, loyalty and shit like that. So, I've tried to adapt that principle, not by talking about it, but actually being about it. You know what I'm saying? And in a conversation that I was having with her, one of the things that she brought up, which is what I brought up to the white people that I'm having conversations with now, is like loud vocal solidarity is going to be the key to letting people know that we're establishing the presence that we want to happen. You know what I'm saying? Or that if it, in any way, shape, or form, that if it does, we're protected because we're protecting ourselves. You know what I mean? And I don't think that it's necessarily your responsibility to do that with matching any donation or anything like that, but I think it's the responsibility of any person who is taking advantage of anything that we do. Do whatever the fuck you want. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, the way I look at it like this, like, there's also, too, there's people, like you know how they say all skin folk ain't kin folk? You know what I'm saying? Like, there's some people who have not had the same black experience as me. I don't give a fuck about what you have to think.
Yeah.
Honestly, at this point in time, yield to the black experience that is the majority, which is the one of oppression at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck about your privileged experience, and my privileged experience right now doesn't matter either. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have to not forget where the fuck I came from in that sense. And remember that I can always go back there. Not because of anything that's in my control. You know what I mean? And, like, I'm letting everybody else around me aware of that now. Like, and that's what our job is, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Like, our job isn't necessarily to, like, I don't think our job is, like, everyone has a role to play right now. And I think our role is to galvanize people and make sure that they can speak as freely as I am right now for every other fucking moment. And they can use this as a point of reference and they can feel like I'm in the room with them or you're in the room with them or whoever the fuck is in the room with them. Because I feel like James Baldwin and Huey Newton are in the room with me right now. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's how, like, I feel like that's how we gotta move. You know Absolutely. What I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. I completely agree, man. I love it, man. I 100% agree. We have to move like that. We have to set that precedent.
Yeah.
Like, and, yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe I should post a donation. I have to go and find it. But,
I mean, like I'll say, it's not your job to, you know what I'm saying? Like, your job isn't to do anything performative in that aspect, and you inform people.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. To bounce off what you said, yeah, I realized that after I donated, like maybe a day after I donated, I was like, it's not enough to just be silent and work in the background. You can do that just for your own, like I'll do that and like move on with my day, but like at the end of the day, it's about being out there and being seen, because at the end of the day, I have fans, you have fans, we all have fans, etc. Like, everyone who has some kind of like notoriety has fans, and we have a, like, not a responsibility, but a power that we can get a lot of information to a lot of people at once. So yes, we have to be like sources of information.